The section where you can take the loss, and there you have to move. So the director already has to move on that. The rest of the next move is having a direction and isolated circuits with the frame in view. The second move is having two vertices which are adjacent and have the frame in view and are connected to the same set of vertices in the graph. Or you can take two additional vertices with the frame in one, which are adjacent. Connected with the same subsets of the vertices in the graph. And the third move can be applied to a different configuration in the three vertices to V and W. The vertex V is connected with only connected with the vertices V and W. All three vertices have the frame and view and the same lines, and the vertices V and W are not connected. So when we attach the vertex to the vertices that are connected only to the vertex V, but not to the vertex W, are connected to the vertex W, but not to the vertex V, and change the sign of the vertices V and W. So we have the three ordinate moves, but there is also an additional ordinate move that responds to the change of rotation circuit. There are two variants of this move. The first is applied to a pair of adjacent vertices with refrain zero, and so we change the sign of these vertices and try to also switch the adjacency of the vertices as shown in the picture. And another move is the local communication move, and it is applied to a vertex with a frame one. So this this move can allow us to pass from one of the rotating circuit to another. So now we can give the definition of the graph moves. It was defined by originally by Luke and Marco, and I think it is the equivalent philosophy to the graph by the regular moves considered in both. And there is another theory based not on rotating circuits, but on transverse circuits and Gauss curve diagrams. It was proposed by Rado and Silva. But this theory is more restrictive because when we work with Gauss curve diagrams, we need to work only with the diagrams of the node, but not me. So, it showed that the theory of interlacing graphs are sub-theory of the theory of the graph. I mentioned that different nodes, different means, different diagrams might have the same intersection graph. It is connected with the notion of mutation, and we learn that mutants curve diagrams have the same intersection graphs. And the next slide, you can see that Chmuck and Andrew proved that the inverse statement is also true. That is, when two curve diagrams have the same intersection graph, and they're connected by a sequence of mutation. So, you can evaluate with parents for graphics that invariance of graphics can be considered as invariance of unoriented virtual links, which doesn't distinguish mutants. So the principle is correct because now there is an unsolved question here. If we have two unit diagrams according to such a graph of concern as graph means, that is, there is a sequence of graph or even as a node. These two diagrams are connected by a sequence of Eisenach Mutter implementation. This is unsolved question. After this question, so we have this principle, so we have some candidates for invariance of graph means and some polynomial current mean variance of graph means. For example, remember the questions were solved by different models. They constructed just the remember for that means. And in my pocket, I consider this operation for a finite homology. In fact, our homology was introduced by Ozak Rasmussen and Sabler. The definition starts with a mean diagram whose persons are oriented. That is, one chooses one of two directions of each person. In this case, any resolution of the diagram becomes a set of circles connected by arrows. And to each resolution, you can and consider its external algebra. And space of chains for all homology is the sum of all these external algebras. The differential is defined according to a changing of the sum. If you have two resolution for space I and j, they that are different at one person, you have two possible cases. And the first case when two circles go to one circle, and then we know where every generator of the space will go, and we can define the differential v of u equals to v, and the generators A and B goes to the generator C. And the other case when one surface leads into two different circles, consider external product of the initial elements by the difference v minus 1. And this definition relates at the ambiguity where the circle and the generator C should be to A or to B. Now the result is the as you see. Next slide, please. Now, the homology are the homology of this complex, where the differential complex is the sum of these partial differentials with some size that makes the square of the resolution and commutative. And I can show that this definition doesn't depend on the choice of the HS elements and the choice of the orientation of the person, and this an invariant of me, which is kind of coincide with the usually analogy in the field theory 2, and as the usual analogy, homology categorifies the Jones polynomial, and there is also a reduced version of this analogy, homology is the sum of two exemplars of the reduced homology. Джонсон Блум defined meditation in Nagan Kyoshin and Pamojin. He explained and noticed that the space, we can be defined through the person. And the initial data for the construction is a resolution that pairs one surface, and that is in a metallic rotating circuit. And then to correct for this resolution, look for matrix E. After correction, according to the linking norm converge. For each two person, can see what configuration that gives on the resolution, and then determine that sign is we should place in the linking norm. And so the diagram now that this matrix is zero. And then, we define the space of chains of the sum of several algebras, and then the spaces of U bar are generated by the coefficients slime XM, and there are some relations between the person that depends on the coefficients of the matrix. And we also define the differential, which is the term of some partial differential with some kind of sign. And Jean-Pierre predicts that this compass calculates the use of current arrangement, its harmonics, and that will change under limitation. So, the current convergence, current convergence of the U2 is notation in there. Thank you. And this slice explains the connection between linking matrix. By the way, the more reduction of the linking matrix is the adjacency matrix of the corresponding intersection graph. And given a code diagram, we can construct my surface F by attaching a handle corresponding to the code of the diagram. And then there is a homology sequence here. And the group H0 of the boundary of the surface F is the group of circles for the resolution corresponding to the code diagram. And the linking matrix is the operating matrix of the net between the two just harmonically. So we can calculate, for example, the number of these circles and the resolution through this matrix. This is the theorem of Coleman lambda. The number of circles is equal to the length of the matrix plus 1. Thank you. And now, we need some minor changes when we plan for the analogy that we need. Instead of linking matrix for the integer entries, we take adjacency matrix of label graph. It is matrix of the two, so we construct home homology with coefficients in the two. And then we consider the sum of exterior algebras, the spaces V defined by the string V. We may forget about size. So we define the space V, and so then we define differential in the same way as was done by Jean-Pierre Blum. So on the next slide, we can consider the homology of this complex, and this homology can be called the Hamiltonian homology of the Euler graph. And the main theorem of my set is this homology is an invariant graph, means that is it is invariant under the Dynastic Mixture graph. Somewhat about the proof. The theorem in the proof includes invariant proofs of Rasmussen itself. We only need to change the geometric reasoning to algebraic ones, and the proof uses some simple facts of homology has to be ready as the homology, which is really an homological gradient, and another gradient is two gradient. But the problem is these gradients are not preserved by the next unit of the ship. So the homology graph means and the current factor as a bi-graded loops, the current as bi-graded loops, so active shift of region. Next question. Here is an example. We can consider the first Boucher abstraction graph V5 and W5, and the loop that is the current homology of the graph. We can see the result. And this shows, for example, that the graph W5 is not trivial as a graph mean. In fact, Vasily Mankov showed by using his third theory that this graph mean is not reliable, that is, there is no a sequence of graph as a master loop, and that it needs a graph which is the intersection graph for some code diagram. The rest of the time I mentioned there some properties of this homology. You can model the point type and graphics and for the graph. We conclude that the harmonic homology of the point actively requires this type of graph, that is, the polynomial of the harmonic homology after the multiplier can start with the type of graph. We can publish distinguished some graph means that consists of one component. We define that not as a graph means that satisfies these derivatives. Here the identity mesh. And so for graph not, one can define a right number by different formula. And here, is the matrix calls only non-zero entry arrives in I-L and I-Column. The right number allows to define a gradient of the harmonic homology which are invariant by the master domain. So, harmonic homology become bi-graded invariant of graph now. On the other hand, the last number is used to define Jones polynomial as graph net, and the problem is parameter homology to give rise to this Jones polynomial in the current then we can define a solution as the graph, that is a diagram of the mean, at vertex. We must take a vertex that either has his radius one, his turning one. In this case, in resolution, when the sum of the vertex is one, is plus one, and obtained by deleting this vertex, and in the other cases, we must apply the force of the last move to change the sign of the vertex and then delete. Thus, we define a resolution of the next part, please. And for those, of course, again, the sequence that includes graph and its resolution at some depth. Next part, please. And these resolutions we have to define a spanning tree length, and we must make resolution at each person, skipping the person and the vertices that are isolated and stress have from zero, and that trainer frontier that are which is a numeric of very spanning tree, and so we have a defined term and it shows that the complex can be converted to a function of complex corresponding to this spanning tree number. And this construction can be used to estimate the complexity of one homology. For example, we can introduce the gens in the following way, and then estimate the thickness of one homology with this gens. For example, the genus is alternating with zero,
one can define the Kaufman bracket, and that was done in the initial paper
question. So how much can one do with that combinatorial notion? So at the first glance, there was only one invariant. But then there were some invariants coming from parity and some examples of knots which are highly non-trivial and highly non-classical and non-realizable. But it turns out that in some sense, one can have the number of non-existent circles in Kaifman states. And one can count these numbers as nullities of some matrices, but in order to define the Havana homology, one has to be able to see how these non-existent circles interact when passing from one state to the other state. And since these circles do not exist, really, this becomes a problem. But this problem was solved by Igor and by using this method of Bloom. So we see that combinatorics of graph wings allows to define really very significant invariants like Havana homology and possibly many others just out of graph information. So that was my comment there. Thank you.
Okay, we have a question.
Oh,
we have a comment. 1 second.
The Lewis and Trolley paper.
They can't hear you.
In the Lewis.
No, you have to use the mic. One second.
In the Lewis and Trolley paper, they show that like huge boxes of those graphs aren't controlled by classical knots. I don't think they know what the visual piece at all, but maybe just those are reference to my components to see that when saying these things are not realizable.
Did you hear?
Okay. I must say that we consider virtual medicines as a diagram of virtual medicine. We realize that in the notes, there is a virtual diagram that holds in this section for which there exists a rotating circuit called in this section graph, can start with the Bloom graph.
So realizable means that there is a diagram you can draw on a piece of paper. You can draw this means that there is some way possibly with vertical crossing. And non-realizable means that there is no way to draw. You have crossings and you don't have anything else. So this means non-realizability. So virtuals are realizable and everything is okay here.
Yeah, actually I'll just point out that from the graph link perspective, obstructing realizability as a classical link is actually really easy. Like if it's not by part type, then
in the virtual case, I think it comes down to the fact that
it's a further generalization. Like we pass from classical knots to virtual knots by allowing non-planar Gauss diagrams. In the same way, we pass from realizable virtual knots to graph links by taking non-realizable graphs which correspond to non-planar diagrams at all.
Thank you.